welcome back. Now you must be one of those people who enjoy a glass of wine after a very long day of hard work. But did you know the process that goes into processing that wine? On Make the Money Tonight, we spoke to a farmer in Barra District who is adding value to grapes and is reaping big from grapes farming.
I'm called Alex Asimwe. I come from Katukuru, which is part of Barra City. And basically, I'm a grape farmer. And from grapes, I add value and get wine under Crepta Wines as its name. Been in this business for quite long. It's now 7 years growing grapes. And after the first or second harvest, I decided to add value because the grapes that I get from my garden, simply because when the market for the ripe grapes was not all that available, so we say that if I can personally add value and come with wine, good wine which comes from grape, because we all know that wine comes from grape, then we'll be able to compete nationally and internationally. What inspired, I already say that I've been in this business for 7 years. And before I was a teacher professionally, and I've been lecturing at Kabarak University for the last 10 years plus. Then eventually I decided to practice grape farming. Why particularly grape farming? It's a high value crop, because like a kilo of grapes, it stands at 3,000. And there is no, I don't think there is any other crop which can sell at 3,000 a kilo when fresh. So, and you, within 1 acre, you can even get 3 tons, 3 to 5 tons, and that's around 9 million per season. So, the value of the grapes inspired me first. And having looked at other farmers, what they are doing and what they are already getting from their gardens, then I decided to venture into that business. And once I ventured in, it did not frustrate me, because as I talk now, I can harvest 5-7 tons a season. That's more than 10 tons a year. But now, then I said, no, selling the ripe fruits itself is not enough. If I add on value and produce wine, then I can be able to get more from the wine, because a liter of wine, you can get a liter from 1.5 to 2 kilograms of grapes, and yet a liter can go to 20,000 of wine. So once you have added value, then you get more value for what you have added in terms of the cost. So that venture prepared me to venture into that business of wine. Like any other production, you need land. And you need land, and land, grapes normally they do well on well-drained land. And basically, maybe on hills, and we do it on hills, on hill slopes, which was formerly Ruampara, but in Nyakairo hills. So once you have land in and capital, you can. You have asked me the size of my garden. Basically, I have 4 acres. Of garden now, but although 2.5 are ready for, they are mature and I'm investing them there, then 1.5 is still coming up. So what one needs is just the zeal and the courage to start the business and to venture into that, because grape growing from the when you are planted to the time of harvest, it takes at least roughly 2 years. And then you start harvesting, depending on how you have tended your garden. And like any other investment, in 2 years, you are able to start harvesting, and by maybe the end of the third year, 1 year after in production, then you are able to get higher yields. And in an acre, you expect to get around 3 tons. And so, it is somehow labor and capital intensive, because you need to have capital, because all it needs, you have to support the plants by either putting on trellis or the lines and whatever, and maybe manuring and making sure that you are controlling the weeds and etc. and the pesticides and the fungicides. So that makes it a little bit capital intensive, because you must inject in some money, and again you need people who have standard the garden on maybe a daily basis to remove the weed and any other, and maybe pruning, harvesting, etc. So you can't say you can do it alone. Sometimes you need to get other people to support you. Basically, my startup capital, including buying land and planting and supporting until harvest, was around 15 million. And this, when you put in around 15 million, you are able to raise to reach the time of harvesting, see the first harvest. And as I was earlier told you, that this takes roughly 2 years. And maybe the first harvest is less, but as you move on at the end of the third year, then you can raise maybe 2 to 3 tons. And how much is a ton? A ton goes to 3 million if you are selling a kilo at 3,000. So meaning that in a period after you have started, when you have started investing, or in a period of 3 to 4 years from the time of planting, you are able to get back your capital that you have injected in. But remember, this is a crop that can last for even 100 years. So it's not a crop that you will plant and tomorrow say and you will plant. No, once you have planted, you have planted. It's a perennial crop and it lasts for over 100 years. Much of what is in the garden. Then as far as the market for the wine is concerned, if you go to the market, most of the wines that you find will be imported wines. And these imported wines, we are talking of, these are from South Africa, from Italy, they all come from grapes. So meaning that the moment there is market for the wine, what is important is the quality of the wine. The moment you have good quality wine from grapes, then the market is there. So long as people have known that there is this kind of wine. Currently is that when some Ugandans have kind of a bias on local products, they feel that the local cannot compete with the international, but it does. Because people have a bias and they don't want to test, they are biased before even testing. But other than that, the grape wine is the same, and if it's good quality, the market is there, because it can stand to compete with international. This is what we go through. The moment you collect them or you harvest them from the garden and you take them to the winery, the first process is sorting them. You have to sort. What do I mean by sorting? You have to get the good ones. You remove the bad ones from those that maybe the should I call them the bad ones. You are sorting and getting the clear that will be go into the crusher or the squeezing machine. So once you have sorted them and you know that this is the clear, in fact, it involves even removing the leaves maybe that would have gone there, and sometimes the fruits hang. Then after that, you crush them, put them in a crusher. It crushes them to get juice. Then after you have got juice, you are able to put it into the fermentation bins. Then this in the fermentation bins, that's where you start the process of fermentation, and you are able to put other ingredients, including yeast and sugar and whatever, so that you are set for the fermentation process. And in these fermentation bins, sometimes it lasts for 5-6 days, and this is when there is high fermentation. Then when that high fermentation has subsided, then you are able to put them in two tanks, the fermentation tanks or the mature, where they can mature from. And in this, you are able to control the flow, you stop oxygen from entering, and the only it releases carbon dioxide that is formed within, formed by the process. So the whole, the tanks remain intact for a period of 6 or more months for the wine to get ready. And then from there, once the wine is ready, you can do some, maybe sometimes you need to filter. Because as it matures, it clears and forms some residues. So you have to filter and get the clear one. Then after that 6 or 7 months, it's already mature. Then you are ready to pack your wine or test your wine and pack it and send it to your market. My production capacity per season is now stands at 10,000 liters and a season, and that means we have 2 seasons in a year, and that means we go to 20,000 liters per year. It will benefit us as shareholders, but again, it will benefit other people, because as we talk right out from the gardens to the winery and to the market, we are employing other people who are getting, who are benefiting directly from the salaries that we pay them. Then the second thing, we are buying from other farmers fruits for supplement. So it means that even the community around is benefiting. So however much it's benefiting us and as a family, as well as the community around us and away from us. Challenge is the period that you keep the wine in the production process. It's a challenge because it has to find equipped to go through that. And when such things like lockdown and how the economy has been closed, then it affects the entire business.
It's pretty obvious that as a farmer, you reap more selling processed goods than if you intend to sell raw materials. Thank you very much for watching. Now, in this show's personal finance segment, we always make sure to bring to you how to spend your money in a wise way, but also how to earn more to be able to sustain your wallets. Now, as the Christmas holidays near and come closer, we are trying our best to make sure you have utmost fun, but also make sure you don't empty your wallet as we walk into the new year. On this week's Personal Finance, we bring to you the tips on how to save for your holiday shopping. Regardless of what your spending plan is for this holiday season, it's still possible to avoid additional debt and save money. As a result, you can still enjoy a festive season without stressing about the repercussions of the new year. How can you make this possible? Well, this week on Personal Finance, we share spending tips that will keep your bank account and savings goals intact. 1. Make a list and check it twice. First, list everyone you want to buy a gift for and rank them by gift-giving priority. As you can imagine, your top priority should be the people most important to you, such as family members. At the bottom of that list, people you would like to buy something for, but it's not absolutely necessary. 2. Set up a holiday budget. In a perfect world, you would begin stashing money away for holiday expenses at the beginning of the new year. Why? When October arrives, you should have enough money in a dedicated holiday savings account to cover most of your shopping. 3. Have a backup gift list. When it comes to gifts, write down a couple of options for each person so you are not tied to a single item and are tempted to overspend if it's too expensive. Having multiple backup ideas for gifts will allow you to compare prices and have choices. 4. Take advantage of discounts and loyalty rewards. Have you purchased products from various retailers throughout the year? If yes, now is the perfect time to see if you have earned loyalty points, coupons, or other rewards. Look for coupons and discounts to arrive in your inbox and mailbox as well. And 5, wait for sales and coupons. While waiting until the last minute isn't advised, in some cases, patience pays off. For example, big ticket items tend to drop as we get closer to the holidays. To take the guesswork out of this, become more familiar with your favorite store's sales cycle or pay close attention to weekly flyers. You can also get notified of special offers and sales by signing up for your favorite store's newsletter. Even if you hate ads, the newsletter will alert you to upcoming special sales, secret sales, and preferred customer sales. Again, as Christmas holidays near, there is so much traveling, there is so much banking, and there is so much activity in the business world. So for you, the travelers, the bankers, and our investors, let's take a look at the Forex and Money Market Reports. Better our show and make sure that you get the best of information on our show. We always take walks around and find out what's affecting our viewers and the communities they live in. So I took a walk around this week to the market and I was surprised what I found. There are women that believe they cannot peel matoke for girls because apparently the girls are meant to peel. As a trader, you should not direct your customer what to buy, but rather help them simply pick what they really want. Another thing that I found out was that some very creative women have decided to pack some of their goods like charcoal in small polythene bags according to the amount they want to sell them at. So I think packaging is always a very good idea for your customers to be able to quickly pick what you are offering. So think about those as you get into a new week and see how best you can benefit from those. The show has come to an end. Thank you very much for creating time. And for our dedicated viewers, we do appreciate your time that you always spend every Thursday to watch. You can always re-watch the shows on YouTube, hashtag The Business Show, and on our social media, Urban TV Uganda and @ Viola Kusasia. Thank you very much once again. Good night.